Okay, good morning to one and all, to my foreign language students. I'm going to record this session for us to be able to move forward in the succeeding meeting. So this is the recap of the previous meeting. So I'd like to share this to you so that we can process the activities that I ask you to do. So in our in lieu of our meetings. So last week, August 27 to 30. So I understand that there are changes in the room assignment and the schedule as well. So every Monday and Tuesday, I'll be meeting with my foreign language students across the College of Arts and Social Sciences faculty room. So that's the old accounting office at the auxiliary building, second floor. So every Friday when we are meeting, supposed to be in person, that would be our schedule for online. So I'd like to take time for processing our Japanese language and culture course during the previous language and history month. Okay, so during the Art of Poetry activity, so I ask you to write and compose your short poems in the Japanese format. Of course, English and Filipino is accepted, especially this is in celebration of the National Language Month. So last August 19, incidentally, is the 146th birthday, as mentioned earlier by our previous recording. So that's the birth anniversary of the father of Filipino language, none other than Manuel Ruiz Quezon. So we had this activity at the National Museum last August 19. So this time, instead of asking the participants to write Filipino short forms like Tanaga, Dalit, and Diona, I asked the foreign language class, so not only the fourth-year students, but also the 3A and 3B section of English language students to compose their respective individual haiku, tanka, and haibun. So thank you so much for doing your best efforts. So I saw and read most, if not all, of your works in the public group that we week August 27, I was able to visit the Polytechnic University of the Philippines, where we launched the three-volume monograph series on Philippine studies. So volume one is dedicated to Center for Kapampangan Studies. Volume two is for Cebuano Studies. And volume three is for Mindanaon Initiatives for Cultural Dialogue. So along with me were my colleagues and peers at De La Salle University Manila and De La Salle University in Lipa, Batangas. So I was fortunate enough to be under the tutelage of Dr. David Michael San Juan, who is incidentally the chairperson, the incoming chairperson of the Filipino Department of La Salle, Manila, so where I obtained my PhD. And one of the Lasallian brothers is the one who translated the old Tagalog prisoner of war from a Spanish document to English. So there's a need to translate this further into Filipino and even to regional languages. So that's the challenge. So on my end, the Center for Kapampangan Studies is written in Filipino. That's a chapter of my dissertation. But also, I was able to have it published, the chapter on CKS, in the Journal of Malay. So the publication of De La Salle Manila. So this is in Filipino as well. But I also prepared an English translation for the same article and dissertation chapter. So moving on, the following day, August 28, I stayed at the Borjaya Hotel. So if you're familiar with the Poblacion district in Makati, so that's the same place of the movie, 3 nights and 3 days and 2 nights in Poblacion. So this is the venue for the 11th Local Historical Committees Network General Assembly. And the following 2 days were dedicated to the National Conference for Local History and Heritage, sponsored by the National Historical Commission of the Philippines. Okay, so the next activity that I had at UP Diliman, so the very same institution where I graduated during my undergrad and even my graduate years. So from 2002 to 2012, I spent 10 semesters in UP. So this is like homecoming for me. So Kapwa Tulungan sa Diliman did push through on the 27th, but on the 28th, there was a declaration of suspension of classes and work. So that's why we had to reschedule. So originally August 28th, but my part is to be a discussant of Bas Umali's book, Pangayaw or Decolonizing Resistance in the Archipelago. So it was moved to August 29. So I was able to participate in the MOOC launch on the topic of decolonization. Okay. So the second and the third day, August 29 and 30, I was able to participate in the National Conference on Local History and Heritage, in celebration of History Month. So as mentioned time and again, so the topic and the theme of the History Month celebration is Salaysay ng Bayan, Saysay ng Bansa. So this enabled me to participate with other colleagues from other parts of the country. So it was announced that the next General Assembly of LHCN is going to be undertaken at Gian Samar. And I think the next National Conference on Local History and Heritage is going to take place at Leyte, so in the Visayan Islands. Okay, so there are some parallel activities. So during the same time that I was invited to be a facilitator of the Art of Poetry, I also had a recording with the Municipality of Buac with Vice Mayor Mark Senyo. And likewise, during the same time that we had the tertulyang pangwika during the same day as the General Assembly of LHCN, I was able to record a session on toponyms and island studies. And it was streamed live, although it was recorded, but it was a stream live. Likewise, the Serbisyong Buakenyo, Serbisyong Senyo All episode on Language Month. So it was aired also in the local cable TV. And finally, last August 31, I had the episode, special episode with the voice of the teachers at Radio DWDD. So I used to host this particular radio show, so Voice of the Teachers. But many years have passed, and I still have a spot in my heart for teachers. So these are the highlights of the August activities. Okay, so moving on, I'm going to share the mechanics for inventory form. So how to fill out the form. So I ask you to take a look at the form, so the Philippine Intangible Cultural Heritage form. So I'm going to discuss in greater detail the contents and how you're going to go about the annexes and the mechanics and the processing of the forms. Okay, so I'm going to share this slide with you for your reference. So again, the context for this is that in Japanese class, not only we make use of Japanese language or Japanese forms, but also we are involved with culture. So culture is very encompassing. That's why I decided to just focus on intangible cultural heritage. So I trust that you had time to take a look at or have a glance of the form. So the flow of presentation is divided into four. So one is the background and the rationale behind the forms. The second part is regarding keywords and key concepts. This is very important so that you can proceed on your own. And the third one, the most important part is the processes. So involved in filling out the form. So, and finally, so just a word of advice regarding the actual filling out of the form. So there are two forms, but there are annexes as well. Okay. So let's proceed. So during my stint in the National Conference on Local History and Heritage, I had the chance to visit the Filipinas Heritage Library at the Ayala Museum. So I did not get to stay long, but I had the first-hand experience of having access to the Filipinas Heritage Library. So the context and the rationale for this is the Heritage Act of 2009, or RA 10066, which intends to strengthen the mandate of the national cultural heritage of the country by conducting cultural mapping programs in the archipelago. So in lieu of that, there's a new stature, which incidentally this September we are celebrating the Philippine Creative Industries Month. So this is because of the law on Philippine Creative Industries Development. So this is PISIDA. So not only we are involved with cultural mapping, but also with creative industries as well. And finally, the other context for filling out the form is we have the Philippine Registry of Cultural Property, or FRICAP. So in Marinduque, 6 out of 6 towns have already engaged with cultural mapping. And at least 50%, I'd say, already submitted their pre-cap forms in the to NCCA. Okay, so more than the local context and the national context, the idea behind the Marinduque Triennale and intangible cultural heritage trifecta, as we are discussing in foreign language and culture. So there's a higher recognition. So there's a international recognition. So in 2003, 21 years ago, UNESCO produced this document. So a convention for safeguarding of ICH. So in the Philippines, this is translated to Buhay na Dunong. So BD. Pero don't get confused. This is also intangible cultural heritage. But I would prefer the translation of pamanang higit pa sa nasasalat instead of buhay na dunong. But just the same, because we already have this document, so buhay na dunong is defined as follows. So binubuo ng mga practice, representasyon, pagpapahayag o ekspresyon, kaalaman, kasanayan, gayon din ang mga instrumento, mga kagamitan, mga artifact, at espasyo kultural na may kinalaman at kinikilala ng komunidad, grupo, at sa ilang pagkakataon, ma-individual bilang bahagi ng kanilang pamanang kultural. So, you'd understand that culture and heritage is intricately intertwined or interlinked. So that's why even in Japanese language and culture, they also have their ICH. But our focus is the commonality between Japan and the Philippines. So we have island studies and archipelagic studies. That's why we draw some light with Morion, Tubong, and Kalitang. Okay, so regarding the form, so PH, intangible cultural heritage inventory form. So PICHI is an activity that is dedicated to certain elements of intangible cultural heritage. So there's cultural mapping, there's Philippine Register of Cultural Properties. This time there's PICHI. So there's a gradual complexity. So don't misconstrue complexity with difficulty. So sometimes other things are quite difficult, but not too complex. On the other hand, there are things that are complex but not difficult. So we can unpack this more in our in-person classes. So there's cultural research involved in filling out the forms, the PICHI, and you have to identify and give characteristics to the intangible cultural heritage. That's the main essence and the quintessential element of PICHI. So in summary, there are five domains of intangible cultural heritage. So as translated, buhay na duno. So one is oral tradition or mga tradisyong pasalita at pahayag kasama ang wika bilang bihikulo ng buhay na duno. So oral tradition including language. So that's where Japanese and language and culture figure in. Next is performing arts or mga sining ng pagtatanghal. The third domain is social practices, rituals, and festive events. So dito kasama yun, ano, Morionan. So mga panlipo ng kaugaliang ritual at mga pagdiriwang. Mga kaalaman at kaugaliang tungkol sa kapaligiran at universo is domain number four for knowledge concerning nature and the universe. And the last domain is regarding traditional craftsmanship or traditional na paraan ng paglikha. So even Morionan belongs to the third domain. It also belongs to the last domain because there's an element of craftsmanship when you create the Morionan mask. Putong is also belonging to the third domain, but as a festive event and a healing ritual or welcoming gesture. Kalutang is also included in domain number three, but the craftsmanship of creating this instrument and ansam like the Indonesian gamelan, so it's an orchestra, a movable feast. Okay, so in sum, these are the five domains of intangible cultural heritage. So oral tradition, performing arts, social events, knowledge about nature and the universe, and traditional craftsmanship. Okay, so this is the main meat of the presentation. So there are nine steps how you're going to accomplish the form. So first, you need to obtain consent. So kailangan ng pahintulot mula sa komunidad. So we cannot bypass this step. There's no other way around. No? So it's important that you coordinate and get permission before you proceed. No? So next one is, you have to plan ahead. Beforehand, you have to lay down the steps and lay out your path. Ano? So there's a planning involved. So pagpaplano at pagpukoy ng buhay na dunong. But then again, we already identified in Marinduque, there are at least three intangible cultural heritage that can be recognized outside the Philippines. So one is Morionan, the other one is Tubong, and the last one is Kalutang. So the first section, AB English or ELS 4 is dedicated for Morionan, section 3A is dedicated for Tubong, and 3B is for Kalutang. And you have your respective collaborators with you. So I'll explain that more in our succeeding meetings. So the third step is to data gather or gathering of data. So again, meron ng mga na-conduct na cultural mapping in the towns of Buac, Santa Cruz, and Gasan, and partially there's also cultural mapping in Mugpug and in Buena Vista. So we already have some data. It could facilitate our data gathering. So the fourth step is to document. So what has already been done. So we don't start at zero. We don't start from scratch. Meron ng nauna na step na nagawa. So what we need to do is to pick off from where they left. So kung meron na nagawa sa Buac, may nagawa na sa Mugpog and Buena Vista. So we're going to consider yung kanilang documentation. So we don't start from scratch or from kilometers zero. So the fifth step is analysis and making use of the gathered data. So kailangan suriin, kailangan ng analysis kung ano yung valid at ang hindi, ano yung pwedeng i-update. So, and you would notice towards the end, towards the ninth step, meron ganun. So pagtatala sa inventaryo. So there's cultural mapping and there's pre-cap inventory. So ito naka-focus lang sa ICH, kaya yung form dedicated for intangible cultural heritage. So not built heritage, not natural heritage, not movable heritage, but intangible cultural heritage. So third to the last step is to build a digital database. So para hindi tayo ulit ng ulit, pinapagawa tayo ng mga forms na ganito. Yung mga LGU, they get annoyed. Pag nagpapaalam yung mga estudyante, pwede po bang kumuha na ganito? Pwede po ba mag-request na ganito? Eh, nagawa na yan. So all things being equal, so let's just come up with a digital database. Kasi doon natin makukuha kung ano yung available online. At ano yung hindi available online, ilagay natin doon sa digital database. So step 8, kailangan natin i-update yung inventory. So kung meron ng inventory, meron ng documentation, meron ng digital database, it needs to get updated. So pre-cap, kailangan niyang gawin every year. Yung cultural mapping, kailangan niyang gawa ng iba pang volume kung meron kulang. So the same token, the same respect is given to PICHI. So kailangan ano din, i-update from time to time. Kaya pagsak sa panahon ng inventaryo. And the last one is periodic review and report. So panapanahong pag-uulat. So if you're done with the first 8 steps, so you need to time and again report. So what are the updates? You have to report to the local government, you have to report to the provincial government, you have to update the NCCA so that NCCA can process this for nomination to UNESCO. So that's the end goal. You know? So here comes the forms. So there are 3 forms. Technically, dalawang form lang yung sinasagutan. So form 1 is about identification of the ICH. So na-identify na natin. So the first form has the objective to contextualize and to provide description for those who are going to review, who haven't experienced Morionan, Tubong, or Kalutang yet. So that by reading the form and without relying on secondary material, they can assess and evaluate the urgency of having the ICH and Marinduque be elevated to UNESCO. So this is done so that even there are different variations and there's pagkakaiba-iba ng perspective in the community, we can pinpoint the commonality, and that's what's important so that we can provide definition and we can safeguard the intangible cultural heritage. So it must be done in a form of inventory by filling out form number 1. Okay, so form number 2 is regarding the viability and what are the safeguarding measures. So I've noticed, so this is quite different from pre-cap and from cultural mapping. So the second PICHI form is regarding the viability. So in short, ano yung kakayahang mabuhay o magpatuloy ng buhay na dunong. So therefore, ang tinitingnan dito eh, viable ba o hindi ka-viable? Buhay ba o nagpapatuloy yung buhay na dunong? So what it involves are activities that needed to be done, how to safeguard. So merong ano yung status ngayon and ano na yung measures taken. In the same regard, we must involve ourselves with DRRM or Disaster Risk Reduction Management. So like say, yung language used or language user, so nakadepende yung dynamics ng language use kung buhay na buhay, conforme kung buhay na buhay din yung mga language users. Kung medyo mas may sakit o may diradamdam yung mga tao na gumagamit ng wika, so therefore medyo endangered yung language. At kung wala na, nagkandamamatay na yung mga language user, therefore at risk yung ating language user. So this is done by the form and provided by NCCA and have some experts with intangible cultural heritage and disaster risk reduction and management in the community. So syempre, kung tayo ay in the Philippine island and so as in Philippine in Japanese context, we are surrounded by from day-to-day basis. We have volcanoes, we have floods, we have landslide, we have these all kinds of disaster, natural disaster. And on the other hand, there are also man-made disaster. So the recent floodings in Metro Manila could only be explained that we have already crossed the threshold of the climate crisis. So it's no longer a crisis, it's an emergency. So actions must be taken and we need to safeguard and to protect our intangible culture heritage. What happens to Morionan if we no longer have the trees that are needed to craft the mask? So what happens to Kalutang if Watingan and Bayugan is no longer available so that we can create the physical and material instrument? So what happens to Putong if the Putongeras and Manunubong die and have health issues because of their old age? So we need to safeguard the culture better as well. So this is involved with the second form or form two regarding viability and safeguarding measures of ICH. So the last part, the form three or annex B, is just a definition of terms. So by the way, the slides that I produce is from that annex. So there's no really form to be filled out. So just be guided accordingly. So meron lang form one, meron annex A, and annex B is just a guide. So I lifted the definition of PICHI and the domains of intangible cultural heritage in annex B. So again, to summarize, so what is at stake here is the preservation and conservation of our intangible cultural heritage, not only known in the country, but to be recognized by UNESCO. So we have Morionan, we have Tubong, and also Kalutang. Okay. So I'll just switch gears. So if everything is in order, so just a matter of summarizing. So I'll have another presentation. So hold on. So I'll stop sharing. So there's one more slide to present. Okay.